Hello guys, welcome to BuddyDevelopers once again, and in this video we will check Geodirectory settings in detail. So let's begin. When you install Geodirectory in any of your website, you primarily get two tabs in the backend. One is places and the another is Geodirectory. In the place tab, you can add a new place or a new business in your website. And in the Geodirectory tabs, mostly all the Geodirectory settings resides. Let's open Geodirectory tab. And inside Geodirectory, the first tab you will find simple analytics of all the Geodirectory related data, with how many listings or review you have, and then you can sort them by different criteria. So the second tab is setting tab, where actually you will find all the settings of Geodirectory. So you will see the different tabs for different kind of settings. So in the general tab, basically you will just get the setting by just reading them. I will explain few important one only. Allow posting without login. You can enable this setting whenever you want a non-logged in user to post a business on your listing platform. The second most important setting on this page is map setting. So here you can set a map API for your directory website, and there are two options you have mainly. One, to set OpenStreetMap. You don't need any API key for that. Second option is Google Map API, and you need an API key and geocoding API for this. It also need a billing to be enabled in Google account. Another important setting is lazy loading map and map cache. So I will recommend to keep the lazy loading to be set to auto and map cache to be enabled on your website, because these two settings speed up the map loading process on your website. So now the another setting is default location. So here you can set a default location for your website, and the important setting is this. If your directory website is not bound to a particular location, then you can enable this setting. It will allow users to add listing from all around the world. So the next setting is pages, and here you will find all the default page template of Geodirectory. You can edit them from here. Since I will explain you everything about how can you edit a page template in detail, so I'm skipping this part for now and we'll check it in upcoming videos. Now we will check title and meta setting. So this setting is basically for SEO purpose. Here you can set metadata for different Geodirectory pages. So when you use SEO plugin like Rank Math or Yoast SEO, then this setting will get overrided, but you will still have the option to disable the override. So search setting is all related with default Geodirectory search form and functionality. Here the main setting is search near radius, where you can set how far from the location user can search a listing. So you can set this location in kilometer or in miles. So in the dummy data setting, you can import Geodirectory dummy data just to check how pages looks with real data. This setting is a bit technical. So if you are not sure with them, then you can leave them as they are right now. The main important setting here is this default design style, where you will see Bootstrap is a new design released by Geodirectory in few recent version, and it is good compared to the existing one. So if in any case it is not compatible with your current theme, you can switch this option to legacy. The last setting on this page is uninstall, where you can set that if you want to remove the data when the plugin is installed or not. So in the email tab, you can set and change Geodirectory related emails. So all the available emails you will get here, and you can check and uncheck them, whether you want to enable them or disable them, like this, the listing published email or listing owner comment submitted. So you can check them here, and here you can change the sender name and email address for all the Geodirectory related emails. And then you get the second tab in this page is admin emails, and here you can change the template of those emails that you have already enabled. And these all emails are only for the admin section, for only for the admin. And you also get an option here to enable them also. So you can use the tags given below and change the formatting. And similarly, you can do that for users email. So you can change the template text or anything you want, just, and you can put the dynamic tags wherever you want them. And then in the next step of design, here basically you don't need to worry about anything, but if you want, you can change the page template of archive page. You can set a page template as you want, but I will not recommend that to do. And in the similarly, you can do that for detail page. In the review section, you get option to change the styling related to reviews, like you can change the color of the stars, and you can change the star rating to something else. That is what you can do here. You can also change the text of different ratings. So basically, this is only for the free version of Geodirectory. When you buy a rating add-on of Geodirectory, then you will get a different interface for managing ratings. So just it is, you can even this is just for the free version. And then in the email template tab, you can change the email template related styling and text. So here you'll see a preview of that. So this is what our email will look like in Geodirectory. Import export setting is very important when you are migrating your site from data from one site to another, or when you are doing some bulk edit operation on in your website. Then you can export the data of your site by just count, or you can export by date also by CPT, and then you click on the export, you will get a CSV file of that data. You can change the formatting or text, whatever you need, in bulk format, and then import it here again, or you can import the CSV file you export it from other website here. And once you import it, it will get updated in your website. Similarly, you can do to transfer category from one site to another, or to bulk edit them. And this is for the review, and same for the setting. And this API tab is basically for app related connection, so we will go not go into it right now, but in future when I will create a video about linking Geodirectory with the Android app or iOS app, then I will explain it better. So the status tab is none of your use, so it is mostly used by the developer or Geodirectory support person to get to know what kind of environment you are using. So whenever they ask you for this, you can just copy it from here and just send it to them. In the tools section, you basically get few automated tools provided by Geodirectory. This tool basically forces the process of installation and upgradation of a plugin. So whenever you face an issue that you are not able to update your Geodirectory plugin or add-ons of the Geodirectory, or you are not able to activate them in any case, in that case, this plugin is very helpful. Sometimes a listing on your website does not show proper count of reviews due to transient cache, or sometimes due to site cache. So in that case, you can run this tool and fix that issue. In some cases, when you accidentally removed Geodirectory default pages, so in that case, you can run this tool and get those pages back. In several cases, Geodirectory category widget does not show proper count of listing inside that category due to transient cache. So in that case, you can run this tool and get fixed that issue. So this is an automated tool for generating keywords by title of a listing post. So this tool is for regenerating thumbnail. So sometime in your website, the images not are in proportion. So in that case, you can fire this tool and get fixed the image size. Some of field related data like field name or field description get saved in the database. So to add translation for such dynamic data, you can hit this tool. This tool will add those text in the language file, and then after you can translate them through bot translation. And then last step here is extension, where you will find different kind of geodirectory extension. You can check them here, and you also have the option for themes that geodirectory provide and recommended plugin that geodirectory recommend, and membership details. So you can go for a membership, and after purchasing membership, you will have an option to activate that membership to geodirectory. So now we will see a geodirectory CPT related setting. So go in a CPT, and then you will find a setting tab at the end. So when you click on this tab, you will find several tabs, and these settings are basically for the CPT itself. The first tab is custom field tab, where you can add a new custom field for your CPT. So I'm adding an Instagram field here. So you can add a title, label, description, and then whether to want to activate it or activate it only for the admin. And you can set it required, and you have the validation pattern or everything. Then I will save it. So now let's drag it little bit up with social media fields. And now we will check this field in front end. So we'll go to the ad listing page, and here you can see the Instagram field has been added here. So similarly, you can add more field and edit them if they are already there. The next tab is sorting tab, where you can add a new parameter for sorting your listing on archive page of your CPT. So you can allow sorting by random, sorting by date, sorting by reviews. You just have to activate it. The next setting in row is tabs. So tabs are basically nothing but the things that are visible on the detail page. So here in the detail page, you can see these are the data tabs, and you can manage these tabs in the tab section. So from the tab section, you can add new tabs or remove existing tab. You can also add even custom tabs using this sort code custom field. Here you can use geodirectory shortcode or even any of the shortcode that you want to add. So I will set a field for social media thing. So let's add Twitter. Copy this shortcode. Let's add the new is Facebook. I will explain you this sort code, how to use geodirectory sort code in upcoming video. So let's save this for now. Oh, let's change the name to something else, like social media. And now check the front end of this. Oh, look, here you can see the social media tab has been added. So similarly, you can add any tab you want for your detail page. In the journal tab, you get few journal settings related to the CPT. So like you can change the slug of CPT to anything, like I've changed it to businesses. You can rename the CPT name to anything you want, for example businesses, and then just save it, and I will refresh the page. So there you can see the text has been changed for the CPT. You can also do few common settings, like you can change the menu icon of the CPT or disable this, enable and disable the comment rating or favorites from here. You also have an option to set a separate page template for the CPT. So if you want something different, so you can set it specifically here when you have multiple CPTs. So in this video, we have taken a walkthrough of all the geodirectory settings one by one. In the upcoming video of this video series, these things, these settings will be more clear to you. So stay tuned, and if you have not liked and subscribed to my channel, then do it, and we'll see you in the next video.